Hey YouTube, what's going on? Today, I just wanted to go a little over port forwarding. I've had a few questions on how to port forward for the servers of Garry's mod, so I just kind of wanted to narrow it down and make it easier to understand. So first off, every router is going to be a little bit different, but if you can find the port forwarding section, it's going to be exactly the same in pretty much every router. So the first thing you want to do is find your router's login. You can sometimes find this on the back of the router, or you can check your IP address. So to check your IP address on Windows 11, you would go down to your network, hit Network and Internet Settings. Whether you have Wi-Fi or Ethernet, click one of those two. And as you can see right here, the IPv4 gateway. So mine is 10.0.0.1. Some common ones are like 192.168.1.1. 10.0.0.1 I've seen quite a few times, and I'm pretty sure there's a few more out there. But you'll just find that, and you'll want to copy that into your URL of the browser of your choice. So, I will say right off the bat, I do have Xfinity Internet, and they did change things on how to port forward, but you should be able to figure it out from what I show at least. So how most routers port forward is you would put that address into a URL. Then you would get to this login screen, or a little box might pop up with a login for a username and password. The default for most routers is admin for the username and password for password. I would highly recommend changing that if that's still your default. You may be able to find your username and password if you can't figure it out from a simple Google search for the default ones, or even on the back of the router. So then you just type your admin and password or whatever it is and click login. And every router is going to look a little different. If you have Xfinity, it's going to look exactly like this. But usually it's in the advanced settings. So under advanced, you see right there port forwarding. Just look around. You can't really hurt anything by clicking links, as long as you don't change any settings, but just try to find where it says port forwarding. Now, I'm going to continue on to how Xfinity port forwards, but you can follow along with your router. So Xfinity now is web-based, so I would go to this link to port forward. Your router will probably be port forwarding in the router itself. So on Xfinity, when you go there, something pops up like this. I'd click my network. I'd click C network, advanced settings, and port forwarding. Now, whether you're within the router or on Xfinity's website, this is where the steps will be exactly the same. So I'd want to add a port forward for Garry's mod, for example. Right here, Xfinity lets you choose your device that you want to use. Now, if your router doesn't let you choose the device, you'd have to type in your computer's IP address manually. To find your IP address, you'd go to where you were to find the gateway. Back down here, right click, network and internet settings, Wi-Fi or Ethernet, and right there's your IPv4. So you would type in, for example for me, 10.0.0.125 as what to port forward. I would highly recommend setting this to a manual setting and making it a static IP so that it can't change on you. However, I'm just going to use Samsung as an example. So we got Samsung, and then you'd want to do a manual setup, and then you would just port forward. So right here, you do 27015, that would be for Garry's mod. It says it's already assigned to my PC, which it is. And then you click next, and that's about it. Anything else that you need port forwarded for, like a Minecraft server, for example, would be 26556 or something like that. I think it's 25565. I think that's Minecraft servers. You would just come do the same exact thing and port forward, and then just next. I wish I could show exactly what it looks like inside most routers, but sadly I have the Xfinity router, so it won't let me show you what it used to look like. But I hope this kind of cleared things up with any confusion. You can do this with any router, as long as you can log into that router, and it will be 90% kind of the same as this. If you have any questions, or you want to maybe show me the router you have and maybe I can walk you through it, I would gladly do that for you. Like I said, I wish I could show more of how to do it within the router itself, but Xfinity switched to web-based port forwarding. Just leave a comment below and let me know, and I will gladly get back with you and try to figure it out for you. I hope this video did kind of sum up some issues that people were having though, made things more clear. I really hope it did. If it did, please leave me a like, please subscribe. It really does help with my future on YouTube. And again, If you have any questions, leave a comment below. I reply to 99% of all the comments I get. And as always, thank you for watching and see you in the next one.